Tunnels have been gaining a lot of traction across the upper Midwest in the last 10 years, and rightfully so. They're in the number one production type technology that's really driving the local foods movement across the Midwest. But what is a high tunnel? Well, a high tunnel is a very simple, inexpensive, greenhouse-like structure with just a single layer of clear polyethylene greenhouse-grade plastic over these structures. So why would you use a high tunnel? Why would you grow in a high tunnel? Well, high tunnels help extend the season, both in the spring and in the fall. So here in the Midwest, we might go from 6 months of growing season out in the field to being able to grow for 8, 10, or 12 months even within a high tunnel, depending on your location. The other advantage to a high tunnel is that it is a desert-like environment. So we remove rain from getting onto our plants, which really helps us decrease leaf wetness type diseases on the produce that's growing inside that high tunnel. That helps us to increase the quality and increase the marketable yield of the produce that is coming out of that high tunnel. So high tunnels are passively heated and passively cooled. They are typically not heated with a furnace. There's no additional fans or ventilation systems to heat them or cool them throughout the year. However, as we look at high tunnels, the difference between a high tunnel and a greenhouse has slowly merged throughout the last few years. We're seeing a lot of farmers put in heaters, put in ventilation systems to help increase the quality and production inside their high tunnel. So here we have our simple propane heater. This is just a standard grill type propane tank. We have a little heating element up here. There's a valve with an off, low, medium, high switch, and a heating element like this can put out about 15,000 BTUs per hour. On this high tunnel that we're in, it's a 30 by 70 high tunnel. You would want to have 3, maybe 4 of these structures or these heaters in the high tunnel. We want to make sure that we space them out, place them in the row in order to get good airflow of that heat throughout the high tunnel. You don't want to set these too close to the plants. This heating element gets very, very warm, and you can actually have some singeing of these plant leaves if it's too close. So again, kind of stick it out here in the middle of the aisle. So here we have an end wall vent in our Gothic style high tunnel. The nice thing about these Gothic style high tunnels is that they have a large ridge up above these doors. So we can put a vent up there that can really help move air throughout this high tunnel. So we've got the doors, we've got the side walls over here that are all opened up, but heat rises, and so we can get a big trapping of hot air up along that top of the high tunnel. So by having these top vents, we can really push that warm air out of the structure. You'll see we have one on both ends. We can even, you know, change this vent here and make it actually have a fan, and we can actually use electricity to push that hot air out. So we can move air from one end of the high tunnel with the fan, push it on through the high tunnel and out the other end with another fan to suck it out. You also have to be on top of things as far as irrigating regularly, because there is no rainfall coming down to the plants. The other challenges with the high tunnel is that you have very different pests inside the high tunnel as opposed to the field. Inside the high tunnel, you're gonna see a lot more greenhouse type pests such as aphids, spider mites, and white flies. This is an irrigation system that comes off of a rainwater catchment system. So we have a marine type battery hooked up to a small electric pump and a couple of water storage tanks. From those water storage tanks, we move down into our manifold. And what's different on this manifold is that we actually have a fertilizer injector plumbed into it. So we can run water, just straight water out to the field, or we can bypass into the fertilizer injector and then out into the field. So here we've got, this would be, looks like half inch header line hooked up to our connectors, hooked up to our drip tape going down through feeding our two rows of peppers. Now that you know what a high tunnel is, if you can overcome those simple challenges, you can really take maximum advantage of those benefits of growing in a high tunnel to add value to your farm system. Putting your high tunnel in the right location on your farm is the first step to successfully growing plants in a high tunnel for the long term. The ideal site for a high tunnel should be in full sun,